Sat Sri Akal, everyone. Welcome to my video log about my path towards Amrit. Today I will be sharing with you guys one of those challenging and obstacles days that I had mentioned on my previous video. And the challenge of today is having a gig at a casino. I've been working with this band for many years. I work with many local pop bands, and one of the works we do often is singing at casinos. And tonight I'm gonna sing at a casino right where the gambling happens, where the slot machines are, right on top of a bar. So not only singing at the casino is a challenging thing because everybody smokes there, the energy is not the greatest, but also the process of working for these bands. I'm Brazilian, most of these bands are girls and Latina girls, and we have a dress code. We all coordinate our outfits, and today's outfit is all white. And number one requirement is show your legs. This is my greatest challenge to become an Amritari. I've been singing all my life. This is how I make money. Not only I have original music, but most of my money that I make is from singing in parties and events and weddings. And because I'm Brazilian and Latina, a lot of people assume, and when they buy the band and they hire me, they want the Brazilian type, they want the sensual appeal to it. And that has been my greatest hurdle on this path. I haven't had a hard time at all letting my kish grow, my head kish grow. As a matter of fact, I have a question for you guys. Do you guys always brush your hair with the kanga, or you, when you get out of the shower, you brush your hair with some other brush that goes well with your hair, and then after you brush with the kanga? Now that's a question. So if you know the answer, please answer right there. But as a woman, I don't think the hair in your head is the hardest thing. Maybe for men, the beard and the hair in your head is a hard hurdle to go through when you are in this path. But for us women, sometimes maybe facial hair, for some of us that have too much facial hair. I have a little bit, not too much. I have not been grooming my eyebrows at all for the past 7 years plus. It is a little different than most people. People do look at me and like, why don't you pluck your eyebrows? And I just let it be. But the hardest thing as a woman, especially a Brazilian Latina woman living in Florida, very hot weather here. We wear lots of shorts. We wear lots of short sleeve shirts because it's just hot. So for us women, the hardest thing is the underarm hair and the legs hair. So I've been able to just choose outfits that kind of do not showcase that area much, but when I come to these gigs, it's almost impossible. Not only people will judge me, but I might not get a job if I don't groom myself. So I try to be a little creative on my outfit choices, and today I did choose a great outfit that has a little more long sleeves, and even though it's shorter skirts, it has a little crochet over, so I think I'm going to get away with not having to shave my legs at all. But that is a great challenge for me. So I know that once I become an Amritari, I won't be able to take these jobs anymore. And I'm okay with, don't get me wrong, I don't want to do these jobs anymore. But that's how I make my money. A lot of my money comes from working with local bands. I'm over singing in casinos, I'm over singing at smoky areas, I'm over having to wear miniskirts, making money not only of my talent, but relying on my appearance, you know? So that's another biggest ardas that I make, that Waheguru Ji figures this out, and I won't need to rely on this type of work anymore to make money, that my capital will come from singing Maharaj's Bani's, Waheguru's Bani's, and mantras and the praises of Waheguru Ji and meditation, music, and just be able to do this full time and move on from this life. So I would like to invite you to come along with me, check out what I do, and give me a word of encouragement. And maybe you can also help me by listening to my meditation music, to my simrans, to my kirtan and my gurbani music that is already on Spotify. So that becomes the main focus in my life, and I can find the possibility to just walk away from all this other work that I do. Come along with me. I will show you my outfit choice, and you take a look of a little bit of my life that I'm trying to move on from. Let's go. So I'm ready. Have a little long sleeves, my short skirt, and feeling ready for my concert tonight. So I cannot keep my hair in any type of covering for this because it's not suitable. So that's another question. Do we have, as an Amritari, keep our hairs covered all the time? Can we just sometimes cover with a shawl, or we have to keep it in a dastar and not show our hair whatsoever the entire time? I have that question. Let me know if you have the answer. Comment down below and let's go to the show. I'll see you later. Ready to go on. This is where we are tonight. Casino, casino, casino. This is the band. The band. This is the place. Pretty busy. Let's go. Time to work.
Everything you have, the things you do, you won't go wrong. Oh no, this is a casino gig. I'm exhausted. It's 11 p.m. and it was fun, but tiring and lots of smoke. A lot of people smoking and I've done that too much. Night after night after night after night, and just for a little buck, you know?
Waheguru Ji Ka Khalsa, Waheguru Ji Ki Fateh. So this is the day after that crazy gig last night. I had a lot of fun. It was great to just sing. I love singing. That's my greatest passion in life. It doesn't matter where I am, what kind of music I sing. Every time I'm singing, I just transport myself to a whole new level, and my body is just filled with joy, and my voice just shows how much I enjoy singing and belting out and just moving to the music. So even though I was at a casino and it was smoky and it was late and it was tiring, every time I sing, it's just magical. This is one of the reasons I enjoy so much Sikhi, because it's all about singing. It's the entire Sri Guru Granth Sahib is music, you know, and Guru Nanak really understood the magic of music. And that's one of the things that made me connect so much to Sikhi, you know, and the magic in the music, the magic in the words. So nowadays, even if I'm singing in a casino or at a party, I choose my songs wisely. I choose positive songs, songs with meaningful words, and I allow the vibration to just flow through me. That's another amazing thing about Sikhi, is that it doesn't matter where you are, you can still connect to Ek Onkar. You can still connect to Waheguru. It's for the everyday life. You don't have to be meditating in a cave in order to reach the source. You don't have to be in the church in order to connect, you know? It's for everyone. It's for everybody. It's for every time. 24/7, you are connected to the source. And I could just continue my life the way it is, you know, enjoying Sikhi and then working and connecting no matter what. But for some reason, I want to go deeper. I want to get to the end of the suffering. I want to get to the end of the ups and downs, the roller coaster ride of ecstatic happiness and crazy depression or anger. I want to just give up that home, that ego, and just surrender to the Hukam of the Guru and just accept all that is and just glide through the ocean and let Guru take me. And I don't know if this is possible with just halfway there, you know, just enjoying the Sikhi philosophy and still having my Manamukh lifestyle. This is why I've been considering Amrit. I want to get to the next level. I want to give my head and finish the suffering. And my career is a big part of my anxiety and my suffering, you know? I've always sang. I was 3 years old when I started to sing and perform. And I've always thought that I would be this big, famous artist. And it never happened. And it was, even though I have so many albums released and I feel successful right now, in the past, I suffered a lot, you know, with that idea of where I needed to be in order to reach the success, what I needed to do, how I needed to look, you know, the songs I needed to sing in order to, for people to like me, to listen. And I'm over this. I don't want that anymore. I'm, you know, maybe because I'm getting older now, I just want to sing. I don't want to care about how I look or who is listening. I want to sing for Waheguru Ji, and I just want to sing. And I just want to feel that unstruck melody continuing within me. That feeling I get when I sing, to just continue resonating through the day, through the years, you know, and not have to feel like you just get that high when you're on stage for those couple of hours. Really felt that rush, and then the rush is done. And then is another couple of weeks working and waiting in anticipation for the next high, you know? That's not what I want in my life. That's why I think I resonate so much to Sikhi and Gurbani and Guru Nanak's message. So I don't know, yesterday was great, I enjoyed, but I came home so tired. And I got home after midnight, and then to wake up for Amrit Villa was brutal. And the high was great, but the lows are tough. So it makes me a little scared. I don't want to give it all up, you know? I don't want to give up my singing career. I don't want to stop the energy I get from when I'm singing high energy, belting out tunes. I love that, you know? But maybe I can still do it, but in a different way. I don't really know. What do you guys think? Do I have to give it completely up in order to take the Amrit and fully commit to becoming a Gurmukh? Or can I find a way to bring it all back in together and still take the next step into my spirituality, but continue aligning with my singing career? So this is my journey. This is my dilemma. This is my duality. And I'm just surrendering to Waheguru Ji, trusting that he will guide me, he will take me, that Maharaj has a plan. I'm just nothing. I'm just here for you, Maharaj. Just take me and do what you will. If you guys have any advice, you know, what do you think? Should I just give it all up? Is there a way that I can connect the spirituality with my career? You know, is there a way that I can continue singing? You know, I don't know. I'm just putting it out there. I'm just, you know, making my ardas, making my commitment to Waheguru Ji and living my life and just connecting to the source 24/7 as much as possible, surrendering, accepting the Hukam, and bringing you along on this journey and see where it will take me. So if you have any suggestions, comment down below. Thank you so much for watching this. I've already received a lot of support from my first video, but I also got a lot of unfollowers, probably older fans that are a little bit confused with this change, but who cares? I'm not here to please the world, you know? I'm just here to follow my heart and discover my higher purpose, which is to connect to Maharaj through music, through chanting, through meditating, and through just living, accepting, and embracing every moment. So once again, thanks for watching. Forgive me for any of my mistakes, or if I have done anything offensive. I'm here to learn, and I appreciate your support and your attention. See you on my next video log about my path to Amrit. Waheguru Ji Ka Khalsa, Waheguru Ji Ki Fateh. Waheguru Ji Ka Khalsa.